visiting my channel, Thinking Like a Virtuous Woman, where I inspire women to think like the woman in Proverbs 31, spiritually, financially, and also relationally. So today I want to take a few minutes and talk about what I have learned this past year, what this past year has taught me and just reminded me. I know it's been a long time since I did a video. I didn't realize it had been 6 months. You know, life just happened. You know, it just happens sometimes. If you know me, you know that I teach. I was teaching at two different schools. I was in the process of publishing two other authors and going into other business ventures. So life got very busy for me, and so that's why I haven't posted a video in a while, but I definitely want to get back to it. I have a lot of things on my mind that I want to talk about, and so I'm hoping to be more consistent again going forward with posting these videos. So if this is your first time coming to my channel, I thank you for coming. If you are a returning viewer, thank you for coming back. And so I just kind of want to talk about this past year, and I don't necessarily even want to say 2020, because it's 2021 now and we are still in the middle of this pandemic. So I just kind of want to just share my heart a little bit and just talk about some things that this past year has really reiterated to me, because these are things that I knew, but it just really kind of reminded me and enforced it for me, right? And one of those things is the fact that we can plan all we want to, but it's God's plan that's ultimately going to prevail. Now, there's a scripture in Proverbs that say a man can plan, but God's purpose will prevail. And that has proven to be so true more than ever. I can remember at the end of 2019, we all had plans about 2020. We had, you know, traveling plans. We had business plans. We're like, this is my year. 2020 is a year of clear vision. You know, there were so many different, you know, slogans for 2020. This was just, I know I personally had some plans for my business. I had just started my online store and I was just planning on traveling more and just so many different things that I wanted to do. And then of course the pandemic hit and it took everybody by surprise. We didn't know this was coming, and it ultimately made us derail, right? We had to cancel the plans that we had. We had to figure out something different. We had to do something different. Like we couldn't even, like, church. I still have not been to church. Like my church, we are planning on opening back up in September, but just the our church events that we had planned, you know, everything went online for those. You know, I know of a few churches that didn't close, a few smaller churches that didn't close, but work changed. Like, we had to change the way we worked. I went from going into a school building every day to sitting on my couch working from home. It just, everything just changed, right? None of us planned this. And so it just really reiterated the fact that, you know, we can have plans, we can have goals. There's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with having a vision for our lives. However, we just have to make sure we submit those plans, that vision, those goals to God, because he's the one that's ultimately, his plan is ultimately the one that's going to prevail. God always has the last say. So that right there was just kind of reiterated to me and enforced to me that, okay, yeah, you can plan all you want to, but God is the one that's going to ultimately decide. Another thing that this past year has taught me, or actually reminded me, because this was something that I knew very well at a young age, was just how short life really is. Many of us, well, I probably could say every one of us know someone who lost their lives during this pandemic in this past year. It just was so many people that were, you know, what they say, here today, gone tomorrow. And it made me want to cherish my life more. It made me want to not take my health for granted. It made me not want to take my life for granted. It made me just want to cherish every moment more, and it made me want to be more intentional about how I'm spending my time. Like, what am I really doing with my life? What am I really doing with my time, with my days, with my free time? What is going on in my life that is not important, right? It just really made me think about how little time we have here. James 4 and 14 says that our life is like a morning fog, like it's just here for a little while and then it's gone. Like this time that we have here sometimes may seem long, these years that we've been on earth may seem long, but they're nothing compared to where we're going to spend eternity. It's nothing compared to how long we're going to be in eternity. And it really made me want to be more intentional about what I do with my life here, because that is ultimately going to decide where I spend eternity. So yeah, life is just really so short. And if you are one of those people that have lost a loved one during this pandemic, my heart goes out to you. This has not been an easy year. Like I said, this has just really been like no other. And the last thing that I want to share that this past year has reminded me, something that I talk about all the time, I hope that more people now more than ever realize how important multiple streams of income is, right? So, you know, if you've been following me for any amount of time, you know that that's something that I talk about all the time because it's very important. Now, many people lost businesses, many people lost their jobs. People are still trying to get themselves together, get afloat, right? Because of losing an employment, right? So this year, I mean, even being in the medical field, I talk a lot about how secure my job is being in the medical field because we're always needed. But I know of many people, even in the medical field, who lost their jobs because, you know, medical offices were closing down. And so it just really showed us that no job, no matter how secure we thought it was, there is nothing that is 100% guaranteed, right? And so this is why we have to have other streams of income, other ways that we make money, other ways that we can take care of ourselves, take care of our families, right? Cover our bills, right? Because your job is not 100% guaranteed, right? So this is why I often talk about looking at other ways that you can make money, right? Whether it's a business that you want to start or whether it's getting another job. Now, we do have to be mindful that having multiple streams of income does not mean that we have to work multiple jobs, right? Because there is passive ways to make income. One of the ways I make passive income is writing books. I write a book one time and I get paid every time somebody buys a book. So that's an example of passive income. You do the work one time and you continue to get paid from that work, right? And so if you are one of those people who do not already have multiple streams of income, I do encourage you to look at other ways to make money, look at other ways to bring income into your household, whether it's active income, meaning you're going to work somewhere else or work multiple businesses, or whether you're going to look into passive ways. So you can always check out my book, Thinking Like a Virtuous Woman Financially. I'll link that down below. I do give ideas in that book, so you can check that out. It's on Amazon. So hopefully give you some ideas if you don't already have any. So I would love to hear from you all. What has this past year taught you, if anything? What has it reiterated for you, enforced, or reminded you? Definitely leave that down below. If you have any questions, any prayer requests, or even video suggestions, feel free to email me. I will leave my email down below in the description box. Thank you again for visiting my channel. Be blessed.